this video, I'm going to be working on my Scriptor Mortis model. This is another member of the Night Haunt. His whole point on the board is to just slowly bleed out the bigger units to death. His ability is he writes your name in his book, and from there you are judged for death. So every round, you roll dice to see if you inflict damage on that specific unit. And for this model, I wanted to work a lot more with shadow and darkness in general, as opposed to my other Night Haunt models. So what I'm going to do is cover him almost completely, except for the book, in a shade of Shaiish purple. And I'm going to be going over him again and again to make sure that it's almost black. You'll still see a bit of the purple when light hits it, but he's going to look entirely black when I'm finished. now that he's finished, I'm going to switch gears and work on his book specifically. So I'm going to start off with some dark stone, very thinned out, and just kind of to darken it up from the eucalyptus primed base coat. And then after that, I'm going to take basilisk brown and fire lizard to give it a very old, worn book appearance. The basilisk brown is just going to go over top the dark stone as a highlight, and then further highlighted and saturated by fire lizard, which is a deeper orange to the basilisk brown, which is more of like a burnt umber.
Thank you.
Now that the binding of the book is all filled in, I'm going to be taking Necrotic Flesh, Skeleton Bone, and Mummy Robes to make a very old, worn parchment color and start to fill in the actual pages of his book. Now that the book is all completed, I'm going to take snake scales, which is a nice kind of neon-y green, depending on what you put it against, and I'm going to use this as my primary highlighting color for Scriptor Mortis as his body in general. And I'm not going to be doing a whole lot of filling in. It is predominantly where light would hit him. And I am going to keep most of his body in shadow. It is purely going off the notion that the only light hitting his body is from his lantern and candles. Now that I have most of his body filled in the way I want, I'm going to take Toxic Mist and go over his hair. Mostly the hair that is above, it sort of trails off and goes under the book. That under strand I'm going to leave covered in the Shyish Purple. go ahead and do some highlights on his feather quill, calling the feather in with crystal blue. And then from there, I'm going to get started working on the candles. I'm going to take some oozing purple and then a warlock purple, which is a good magenta color. And oozing purple going down as a base on the melted waxy bits, the wicks and everything, and then highlighting that with warlock purple, having the flames cast that magenta glow. With base coats done, I'm going to be working on a bit more highlighting, so I will be going into all of the candles and bits of the lantern and touching them up with some pixie pink just on the edges where they would be most bright. And then I'm going to take some more toxic mist and go back over just the top edges of his feather quill to highlight them as well. And then I'm mostly satisfied with how the model looks at this point, so I am taking Warlock Purple and Snake Scales and just marking out some spaces on the base, because there's not a ton of detail on his base compared to other Nighthaunt. I was trying to think of a way to give a good cracked earth effect, even though I don't have any terrain paste or any other things like that to kind of simulate terrain paste. So I'm going to just take those two colors, make some stripes on the base, and I'll be going back over it later with Shyish Purple. last bits that I'm going to add to the model is I'm going to take true copper and use that on the edge of his quill, the pen part of his quill, and the lantern and candelabra attached to his spine. Finishing touch to this model, I'm going to take some necromancer cloak and just scribble some scrawl on his book to make sure it is just has that little extra detail to it. Everything I like to do, I'm going to take matte black. I might get some black 3.0 or something at some point to start doing this with, but for now, matte black around the edge of the base. Done, and here is how he turned out. I was really pleased with how he turned out. I thought this was a good representation of what I wanted Scriptum Mortis to be. He's just kind of this creepy unit that you keep in the back of the army. Might make him your general and load him up with some cool abilities to help the rest of the army, because after his ability to doom other units on the field, he really doesn't have too much going for him. He's not a great melee fighter, he doesn't do spells, and he doesn't have any ranged. So if you have him on the field, you usually probably put him as your general and give him an ability that helps buff the rest of your army and keep him out of combat. And thank you for watching.